I will just tell you one, and that is exactly when I pass Boxbar Stadium, how I feel. It's like when I go to the cemetery and then look at my father's graveyard. The shock at that moment by standing at my father's grave is the same shock that I do have when I pass in those areas. There is a saying, this is a language in recruitment. When you are a recruit, whether a soldier, whether a policeman, or whatever, when we do in our road running, we do sing a song. That is to say, Niyalo imam bambang, musol kane dun kuba kera. We will enjoy this and be happy. That is to say, if you know that you are not fit, don't join the service. Service is about hard training. So if GFA knew, the GFF, if they knew that they cannot build the entire recognized zones field together, they should not have destroyed in the first place. They should do it simultaneously. A project as per project. Within our sub-region, Murutani, the same fund the GFF received, the same fund that Murutani received. Murutani did it gradually. They did it as per field. After completion, they shift to another. After, they shift to another. But because these people, Niyalo Imam Bambang, because of sport politics, they want their names to say, Kaba Bajo, Kaba Bajo, Bakari Jami, Bakari Jami. When they know they cannot do it, they dismantle all the entire recognized fields at one go. There is no naweta. Intellectuals, you need to pre-plan before the actual project. Hadn't been they destroyed Birikama, destroyed Kere Serekunda East, left to West, Banjun and others, then the Nawetan can even be sifted. But Serekunda is not playing, Birikama is not playing, West is not playing, Banjun is not playing. How can we get our nucleus of the talents players from grassroots? And annually, these are the places where we get our talents. But because they want big name. We were doing football. I was the second vice president of the GFF. Then under the Seedy Kinteh regime, Seedy Kinteh was doing good. Just a match against Algeria. Bakari's brother, the former minister, youth and sport, Aliou Jammeh, has to impeach and terminate us. Now, he dissolved the entire executive of Seedy Kinteh. When we were at our first time to develop sports in this country. Today, what goes around comes around. Today, that minister's brother is the man, soul, whole of the project manager of those zones, those parks. And the money is available. The contractor, through your interview, the contractor even pre-financed it to a tune of $2 million. And nothing. Some fields are not untouchable. How disheartening and disrespectful to approach Bakari to throw light on those things and he refused to comment. You can talk to people. It's an allegation. Talk to the people to say, yes, what you said and what is happening is different. Or what you said, that is the truth. But because of you to receive nangam, that's why it's not happening. But you feel you own people. You don't want to talk to people. You destroy the field, promising us that you're going to build it within 6 months. We're going up to 1 year, 6 months now. You are not talking to people. You didn't go back to those people. And the saddest part of it, the people that are affected on the grassroots are not involved, are not privileged to see those contract documents. People are keeping quiet. I said, if you touch this thing, it's like if I am standing beside the graveyard of my father. The shock I have that I cannot do is only Almighty Allah. Whatever he decides, that's what can. But if at all, for someone to die, you will not allow your father or your mom to die. And there will be no death. The shock that I have is the same thing that when I passed through. Because that Brikama field, I'm the solely founder of those artificial top. So seeing those artificial top being bunched and thrown without no replacement, a better one. No, I feel so sad and shocked. And then people are just keeping quiet. Nobody wants to talk about it. Why? Why? Who is this GFF under the leadership of Kaba? Who are they? It is the worst committee ever have in this country.
Many are saying grassroots football is dying.
It's dying. Is that sport development? You put in sport politics before sport development. This is the worst committee we get never have, and people are not talking about that. Look at their composition. There is a saying in FIFA that you should not involve in partisan politics.
Yeah, that's true.
No, when you are doing an administration in football.
No football authority is involved in politics.
In partisan politics. We have seen where we have a major, somebody in the executive has to go and contest for the mayoral election. Right or wrong? We have seen an executive member or an opposition as executive members like treasurers and whatever. Right? We have seen an executive member here as a first or third vice president as a politician, Slanton Montamba, APRC. Right? We have seen a politician, APRC, again, Parmatar. These are all members of the FA. We have seen Bakary has an interim committee, mayor leadership. We have seen even conducting as chairperson for the election, the AGM of an opposition here. Nobody is talking about that.
And FIFA clearly states that no president.
Nobody. And during our time, Bakary was among the people who pre-financed our termination in a meeting. I am telling you, are telling me huge association. I have my documents, whatever I'm telling you, I have my evidence, you're telling me that. At Umar Sy's house, this meeting was held there, before the jail. And now, that's why I said, what goes around comes around. Now he's the first vice president of the Gambia Football Association. What is he doing? With all these accusations, let them. It is there in the constitution. I am not blaming them. I am blaming the actors. The actors are the club owners.
Stakeholders.
They are the stakeholders. They are the people who put these people there. You cannot put somebody there for your interest and it's going contrary to your interest. And you still leave in the person there.
What do you suggest?
What I suggest is simple, Nana. These people should go away and concentrate in their politics. Sport has nothing to have a partisan politics in it. If you want to touch them, they go to a political leader where they will have a lunch, breakfast, attire, there just to bag them. We know it. We know it. If you don't interview me about the status of Brikama field, I will not talk. Because even today, Brikama, they're crying. We want this thing to come back. It is their business. If you don't interview me, I will not talk about this. But this is the fact. We are all Gambians. We are all stakeholders. We don't go out of sport. Even Seedy Kinteh that you are talking of, he didn't go out of sport.
Seedy Kinteh ran away and went to
Boston. No, he is on post. He's on duty, he's on posting. But Seedy is involved in sports. Keeping quiet, Seedy is sponsoring a club here. I am keeping quiet, I'm sponsoring clubs. We do assist. We don't involve in their administration. Because if you want to involve, they will say it is King or Seedy or this, that is are sabotaging us. We want to leave them free mind so that they do whatever they want to do. But if they go wrong, we are going to talk. And they are doing it wrong. Before you demolish 4 or 5 fields, why can't you do one and develop that? If that one is completed, you start with another one. But at one time, because Musholle be chochoka ni halo imambamba.
But the second vice president Ibu Fahy have came out clearly to say it's a failure. The projects are a failure.
I respect Ibu. I love Ibu. I like Ibu. And I will repeat. I respect Ibu. I like Ibu. And I definitely honor him. And I swear, billahi, wallahi ta'ala, even today, if Ibu should say, I want to stand for the presidency of FA. Huh?
Ibu Fahy.
For the presidency of GFF. I will vote for him. You said it. He always said the truth. He's very truthful. If he did what is wrong, you confront him, you tell him, yes, Mr. Kla. I heard your interview. He said, Degala. And if you go further, he will tell you, I'm not aware.
Yeah, he told me.
You see? You know, when he was telling you, I was not there. I know him. There is nobody within the sport fraternity who doesn't know King Colley. And there is nobody who is definitely deeply involved whom I, King Colley, didn't know him. And I can tell you, each and every one of them, their character. I don't even know why they should even give the contract to Bakary. Bakary, Tom Monjata, they were the one who was holding Gambia for gold. Gambia for gold. And it was a total failure. Up to now, Gambia for gold never come to the Gambian people to tell them, this is what we have, this is what we spend, and this is what is left.
Well, you're talking about Gambia for gold. This reminds me of the recently, you know, commissioned team to raise 117 million for our national team to Cameroon. The people you are mentioning are there again, like Bakary.
Yeah. Anywhere where money is, Bakary one there.
It's sad.
He's my brother. All my life and everything, I do spend it in Bakary's house when I'm in Farafin. But the truth is the truth. I never hide the truth. Anywhere money is, Bakary Jammé is there. First Vice President responsible of finance, GFA. Let's go. First Vice President, GFF, is responsible of finance. Bakary is there. Gambia project, Gambia goal. The renovation of there, Bakary was there.
Yeah, the famous 1.5 million.
5 million, Bakary was there. The renovation of the field, Bakary is there. The head of the delegation to the Birmingham Olympic, money, Bakary is there. Yeah, so the truth shall ever remain the truth. And Bakary is not better than anyone in football. He's a good brother of mine, very good brother of mine. But let us be very careful.
Finally, what message would you have for Gambian sports lovers?
For us to come together and take back the ownership of sports in this country. Let it give it to the right people who can develop sports. I thank you.